Krishna Prabhu, but like you mentioned in your talk that to have a relationship with the Paramatma, you should completely surrender unto him. And I mean to know like what it means to surrender completely unto Paramatma, Supreme Personality of Godhead, and how to surrender.
No, that is the instruction Krishna, tameva sharanam gacha. Tameva sharanam gacha, you completely surrender to him, that's a goal. So it is not that you start your relationship with Paramatma only when you completely surrender. If that is a misunderstanding, it's not. Ye etamam prabodhyanse tam state bhajami aham, Krishna says, as you surrender, I reciprocate. Some places you have material desires, you don't surrender. Some other places you have no material desire, you surrender. So he reciprocates. Basically, if you surrender to the Lord in pursuance of taking forward the following the instructions of spiritual master, and that is a measurement of surrender, following the instruction. So if you follow the instruction, there are two things. One is absolute surrender, another is surrendering process. So both are surrender. Today we are in the surrendering process. Krishna will reciprocate. Karmis, they are not in the surrendering process. Prabhupada is absolutely surrendered. But we are not absolutely surrendered, we are in the surrendering process. That means to different degrees, in different aspects we are surrendered. So our goal is to become completely surrendered. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya. Take complete shelter of the Supreme Lord. And every thing that you do in this world will be like an order carrying of his instruction. The spiritual master is a personification of Paramatma. If there is a walking Paramatma, that is a spiritual master. You want a walking Paramatma, you want a talking Paramatma, that is Prabhupada. Therefore it is said that one should not consider spiritual master to be an ordinary person. Because he has no other business. Only Paramatma is working through him. Nobody, no Maya is working through him. So your question is, if we are not pure, how do we surrender? How do we start a relationship? This is not correct understanding. God is a person. He looks forward towards you as a person. He is not a technical person. When is the day 100% surrendered? There's a hard line one day. Nothing like that. You are a person. The very fact that you're chanting Hare Krishna means something you have surrendered. 2 hours of your life you have surrendered. If you're chanting 16 rounds. Then how I can develop the spontaneous surrender or intimate relationship with the Lord? Simply knowing that, I mean, there's a person inside me who knows everything about me. I know only about this life at the most, which also I do not remember. What I did in my childhood, what all nothing. You know, one person who knows all these things, everything that I did in my childhood, all good things, all sinful activities I am doing, everything he knows. Very intimate. And he is there to help you. And he says, ye yathamam prabodhyanse tam state bhajami aham. So why not we do something? Why don't we strike a relationship? For this you need mauna. You need to hear this, you have to read from Bhagavad Gita what Krishna says about the super soul, and then spend time. And then be courageous. Anything prescribed in the Shastras, go ahead. Go ahead and talk to the super soul. It's one of the processes of a sadhaka. Nectar of devotion says we should talk with the Lord in the heart. It's a sadhaka's duty. You know, going because we are all anu, no? We all have problems. When you become a devotee, all your problems are also devotional problems only. They may be material problem, even sickness may be material problem. But they are all ultimately, they turn out to be devotional problems. Because it disturbs your sadhana, it disturbs your service, everything. Right? Whom will you talk to? Talk. We are all so much addicted to talking outside. We should make a philosophy. Talk to Paramatma. That is truth. Truthful talk. And then through our intelligence, you will get reply. You will get in the form of realization. Because now, we can talk to Paramatma, but we cannot hear him. Since we cannot hear him, so Lord has to work through our buddhi. Your answers will come through the buddhi and not by a reply, direct reply. For Prabhupada, reply direct. For us, we are all insensitive. His voice we cannot hear. If at all we imagine his voice, it will be Maya's voice. So you talk to the Lord, but don't imagine he's talking to you back at immature stage. But have faith that he is talking to me through intellectual realization. He'll mix his direction into my buddhi. Om ajnana timirandasya jnananjana shalakya. Through torch light of knowledge, my directions come. My instruction, my direction comes. So that is a process. You talk to the Lord, it's not one way. The other way, your intelligence is getting, you're getting the direction from the Lord. There also, you need consultation with Vaishnavas. It is obviously you can ascertain instruction from the purport, it's fine. Otherwise, you need direction from that, because there also, just like Maya will talk, Maya also, all the intelligence that we have is Maya intelligence only. Is it not? So there, Krishna's light has to come. Krishna's intelligence, you can differentiate. You will differentiate it very easily, because Krishna's intelligence, when it comes, it has a life in it. It is not the power of logic. Normal, our intelligence, there is a power of logic. But Krishna's intelligence is like it has got its own light.